real. No phone, no Twitter, no gram, just feel. Posted in the trap, selling niggas EDD. Call of Duty on me, niggas not robbing me. Left, right.
That's a little bit of Larry Jones, though. That's Larry Jones right there.
That's one of your homeboys from back
no,
home.
No, it ain't. He from the Bay.
He got a little bit of rappers but he know from back home.
He from the Bay.
Dude working at Domino's out here trapping out the band, though. I don't know what he's doing.
You, Larry, really, you want a little snippet? I'll give you another snippet if you want this.
I'll insert it in the video.
If they pull a nigga over, I might take another L. I ain't really been the same since they killed my nigga Lil. Riding with a ghost, 40K, shit get real. No phone, no Twitter, no gram, just feel.
Okay, you're talking about
relationships. When was your last relationship? I ain't been in a relationship in like 5 years.
My last relationship, my last, with a title on it?
Relationship, that's your girlfriend when you're home, when she
freshman
was
year,
home.
My freshman year coming into college, I had a girlfriend. After that, we broke up. She was racist parents. Since we're on the topic of racist parents, let me tell y'all something. To all y'all parents out there, do y'all know how stressful it is? And all y'all girls out there, do y'all know how stressful it is to then go being a black dude going to a white girl's house for the first time?
That's scary within itself.
I'll give you an example. Okay, first white girl house I ever went to. First white chick at house I ever went to. I go over there. Mm-hmm. I don't remember the girl's name. Don't even remember. I was like 14, 15. I go over there. Her parents cooked dinner. Everything was cool. Everything was fine and cool. Until we got to dinner. So, her dad's sitting directly in front of me. Her mom's at the other end of the table. Mm-hmm. Her brother's on this side of the table. Her mom brings out fried chicken. First flag. Fried chicken. I'm like, all right.
What's the season?
I'm about to get there. Okay. She brought out fried chicken, right? So, everybody gets their chicken. They had this little fork thing. You don't know, only white people got to eat them. Everybody else just grabbed the chicken off the plate. So, they had this little fork thing. I put it on my plate, right? So, as I'm looking out at the chicken, we done prayed. Everybody in there is sitting quiet, and then I look up, I look around, they're all waiting for me to take a bite of the chicken to see if it's good or not, to see what I think. I ain't gonna say that was weird, but it was just weird.
Red flag.
Yeah, it was red flag, man. So, all right, that happens. So, boom, everything's good, we talking, we chilling. And so dessert comes. And, you know, what do you consider dessert?
Banana pudding.
Yeah. All right.
That's
so exactly
dessert.
Banana pudding dessert. I think anything that you wouldn't naturally eat for dinner is a dessert.
Like a sweet. So, something like sweet.
Yeah, something sweet. Ain't potato chips ain't no dessert.
Ain't no dessert.
You in college. We know you all eating noodles and all this other stuff, but still. Hey, when I say her mama brought out two giant slices of watermelon. I mean, cut up into the sections with the triangles, perfect for dessert.
She racist.
When you put chicken and watermelon together, what you think, Nick?
What were the sides?
For dessert?
No, when y'all was eating the chicken. Y'all know y'all ain't just have the chicken.
I think, what was it? It was, they had some stovetop stuffing, which I didn't even know what that was at the time. And I think some macaroni with some little bacon in it. And I thought that was crazy because to me, I was always told that white people use. Do you think macaroni is a side or is it a main course? Y'all tell me right now in the comments, do y'all think macaroni is a side or a main course?
That's a great question. I always eat on the side. I think it's a side.
Do you think macaroni could be a main course?
Why can't it?
Macaroni is a side dish. If your main course is macaroni, you ain't eating. You're gonna be hungry later on that night.
Did they give you macaroni as a main course?
No.
Oh, so they put it
aside? No. Macaroni is a side dish. Do not eat macaroni as a main course. That's all I'm saying.
So if I'm going to dinner, don't just get no macaroni. Like, your mom, you'd be like, mom, what's for dinner? She had macaroni. What?
Exactly. You gonna want something else. You ain't only eating macaroni for dinner. Unless you damn bad. I can see if you a damn bad. I see a college student, man.
I'm talking about like, I'm playing the game middle of the night. I'm going downstairs. What we got in the refrigerator? Like, I heat up the macaroni. But I'm not finna go home and say, Mom, yo, I'm waiting all day. Tell me what we eat for dinner.
Macaroni. Rice-a-roni for something.
You looking at, all right, so macaroni, what else? Like, chicken ribs, pork chop, like what? Like, hold on, nah, you ain't finished. Chicken, watermelon, stovetop stuffing.
The other side, I think it was mashed potatoes with this gray beefy gravy. It was weird.
All right, so that's the only thing racist.
And cornbread. Yeah. So I mean the thick cornbread. I mean like she went to the name Publix, the good to get this. You know they ain't Costco or something like that. Rebels Outlaw. Something like that to get that food. Goodness. Man, I'm telling you, this cornbread was thick. I mean, you bite it and it instantly just sink into your mouth, watery. I mean, the cornbread was popping.
So she did all this for you, I know she did.
It was a racist meal. Like, I ain't gonna call it racist, I'm just saying that she tried to please. And her dad made it very clear. Her dad was like a basketball or a football coach, and he just kept reiterating that he was so happy that his daughter doesn't see color, and that how he thought Obama was such a good president.
So how long has this been going on, this thing?
And this is also the same guy that I saw posting about, I ain't gonna say nothing about Trump, but he was voting for Trump, big Trump star. I got friends that, do you think just because somebody voted for Donald Trump, they're racist?
I don't know. Well, he done. If you think about everything he done did,
both good and bad, he did some good things.
Everything he said, everything wrong that he done said, and you done still stuck with him, and you voted for him, I have questions.
Exactly. Especially if you dating a black dude. You dating a black dude.
I have questions. I have questions if you black and voted for him.
So, Nick, you ever had a bad relationship, just a straight-out bad relationship?
Yeah.
Tell me about it. Give me a little story. You ain't got to say the name or nothing. Just give me an example of a straight-up bad, what you would call a straight-up bad relationship.
A straight-up bad relationship is... like when there ain't no trust involved, and then you have a girl and she don't, or she tell all her thoughts to her friends, mm-hmm. but don't tell you none of what she's thinking. So she go around spreading all these assumptions or rumors or whatever she's heard mm-hmm. from them, and she going to have a conversation with them, but ain't coming to you directly like, hey, this is how I feel. Mm-hmm. This, you know, I heard this was going on. Tell me what's up. Like,
no communication.
Very no communication is key,
especially in college. Because if you got a girlfriend in college, dudes are boys. I ain't even call them men. So a lot of dudes is boys out here.
Boys transitioning.
If you try to talk to a girl and somebody else, especially if you go to a small school, if you try to talk to a girl and somebody else, this could be a chick that you could have seen this girl every day, and everybody else thought she was ugly. He could have thought she was ugly every day.
Yeah.
He sees this, he finds out that you're trying to talk to her. He gonna try to talk to her just because he know you talking to her.
That's a fact. I'm saying.
And if you in a relationship, dudes will really be out here and be like, man, I hit his girl back when blah, blah, blah.
Right.
And now you over here stressed out trying to figure out your girl cheating, messing your own relationship up.
Yeah.
How do you view relationships, man? What's your thoughts on that?
My view on relationships, it be good, like, when it's the right time, it's the right, like, y'all know, like, if you really vibing with this chick and she really vibing with you, then, you know what I'm saying, y'all see where things go, but it gotta be communication there, it gotta be trust there, it gotta be effort there on both sides for anything to work. If you lacking in any of those areas, then it can go south real fast.
I'm gonna just throw out some phrases, some of my thoughts on relationships. Mm-hmm. And you just tell me how you feel about it. Y'all too. Y'all tell me down in the comment section how y'all feel about this. I feel like a woman does not deserve a good relationship until she done had at least two or three bad ones.
You said a woman does not deserve a good
relationship. I don't think a female deserves a good relationship. A good man, a good strong man until she went through a couple bad ones.
For like experience.
Yes. And more. I feel like, how you gonna know how good, you ain't gonna know how good that relationship is until you've been in a couple bad ones.
That's a fact. That's valid. I see where you're coming from.
Y'all, okay, you see where I'm coming from.
Yeah, I see where you're coming from.
Because a lot of females out here, you might have a good man, but you don't know how good he is until you got something to compare him to.
Right.
Just like Nick, tell the truth. If you be with a girl long enough, you gonna know what type of men she like. Right?
Mm-hmm.
So therefore, you know what type of men your girl like. So therefore, if you see a man that you think has a chance to like take your girl away from you, are you gonna feel a type of way? Like you see, if she's around this man.
How's she acting when she's around him?
Around?
She ain't like too friendly.
She, I ain't gonna say she's too friendly, but you can tell that you just know that she's interested in this man because you know how she is.
Mm-hmm.
So therefore, you know if this man's cute or not to your girl. Do you believe that? You know what your girl think is cute.
Yeah.
So you know if a girl, if this man's cute enough to be with your girl. So you know what men is cute and what men is not.
Yeah.
To that woman, you know that, right?
Yeah.
All right. I'm just making sure. Y'all tell me if I'm wrong now.
That's true.
Alright.
You're gonna feel some type of way. You're gonna be like, alright, especially if you're someone sort of affection towards them.
You said you what, 6'5", right?
6'4", yeah.
You said 6'4", 6'5". You say you mess with a chick that's about 5'2", 5'3".
Mm-hmm.
So y'all been messing around for a while. She always telling you, I love tall athletic dudes. Out of nowhere, y'all at a party. Yeah, just the day before y'all was watching a big game, March Madness.
Mm-hmm.
And the same dude that just hit that buzzer beater come in the room. The same one she was screaming for the night before. And you gotta go pick something up. You gonna leave your girl with her friends. You gonna leave it there or you gonna take it with you?
Take it with me.
No, you
coming it with me.
So you don't trust him?
No, you knew he was gonna be here. And you seen what he just did. Come on. No, I don't wanna know that.
Where's that communication?
I'm gonna tell you right now. Mm-hmm. This is what you don't know. And I heard this.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so you got a girl, right?
Mm-hmm.
And a dude DM her.
Yep.
Is she supposed to respond? Is she supposed to leave it on scene and respond? I mean, is she supposed to leave it on scene and not say nothing? Or, you know, is it a response? It don't matter if it's friendly or not. You just be thank you. Because word is, if she responds, then she is accessible.
Every woman is accessible. Can I put it like this? Every woman categorizes. Categorizes men in a certain way. So I'm gonna put, if your girl, even though you with your girl, she gonna look past that message. She gonna click on his little Instagram. She gonna look at all his pictures. She gonna see a whole lot before. Like you say, you 6'4".
Mm-hmm.
A 6'8" dude that play in the NBA DM your girl. You think she gonna tell you or DM him back? Just a regular female. Y'all been together, what, 2 weeks?
Two, 3 weeks.
2 weeks. Y'all been dating 2 weeks.
I don't know. I've been with 2 weeks. She probably will respond.
She probably going to respond to that message.
She probably going to respond.
Do you think she going to tell you that she responded to that message?
No.
Every woman's accessible.
Females be just as sneaky as dudes, and they be trying to really downplay that, and I don't like it.
You know the difference is? Females don't get caught. But when you do catch a female, but I ain't gonna say that all the time, because some dudes, they'll cheat on their girl. They could be in the best relationship ever.
Mm-hmm.
They could cheat on their girl every day. Still mm-hmm. have a best relationship. But the second they feel like their girl doing something, we gotta hold this dude's hand as the homies and be like, bro, I don't know how my girl cheated on me. I don't know why she would do that. And I've been watching this man cheat on her every weekend. Every 2 weeks. Is that wrong or right? As a homie, would you tell his girl?
I ain't telling his girl
either. I ain't gonna lie.
I'm gonna have to tell him by himself too.
Yeah. I might tell the homie something. I'm gonna say something.
I ain't gonna tell his girl though.
But when he's sitting there crying that his girl done cheated after he been out here swinging to all them freshmen. To all them freshmen. Cause they quit. They quick on their feet.
Honestly. Their freshmen is different.
Nissans too. Something that Honda Accord to get you. Man, if you gotta focus. You better focus. Focus on yourself if you got to focus. If your daughter drive a Focus, if the girl you like drive a Focus, you might as well just focus on yourself. That's all I'm going to say. Because time is going to be hard for you. That's all I'm going to say. But let's hit a couple more of these points, Nick. What we got?
What else you got? Yeah, I forgot. Hold on.
How would you feel if a girl said you was her second best boyfriend? Like, you know what I mean? Not just boyfriend, but everything. You was the second best at everything she ever had.
She's still with me.
Y'all still together. But are you going to wonder about who's the first? You the second best at everything, every aspect of that relationship.
That's tough. But she with me, so she going to know.
So you ain't gonna feel no type of way? You're not a bitter man?
I ain't bitter at all.
I'd rather be third place. I ain't gonna lie to you. I'd rather be the third best than the second best.
First of all, you and me, so you know you were the best. I don't care what you say.
Not me, on the other hand. I am a horrible person. I'm the dude that's gonna ask a girl her body count within the first couple days. I'm saying that was me when I was younger. Cause now, I ain't gonna ask you nothing. I know I don't want to know.
Because once you know it, you know.
Because once you, if a female don't tell you something, you don't know.
That's why I'm down bad right now.
Down bad movement, man.
Stop getting around.
Because if I don't know it, I don't care. If we go to a party with a female, she could have had sexual relations with 30 men that's in that party. Just in that party. I seen her hug one dude. You gotta think about it. So if your girl hugging dudes in parties, there's already a problem there. But hey, if I don't know she messing with any of them and she ain't giving off no signs, then I don't know nothing. I could walk by 10 dudes and they could snicker smile. I'm just be ready to fight a dude because I think he's talking about me.
But if you ever smash 30 dudes and they all at the same party that you at, sweetheart, I'm gonna let you know something right now.
You're a Frenchie.
You're nasty.
And you're dropping me something.
You are nasty, and you deserve a butt whooping. You're nasty.
You probably drive a white car too. Mm-hmm. Probably got the little.
If you have ever been at a party and there's 30 dudes in the party that you can count off the top of your head that you can see in your view. If you can count five and they all at the same party.
You can count five, there's a problem. Big problem.
You're nasty.
You're big nasty. Tall, right?
Yeah.
I'm averagely tall.
Mm-hmm.
I'm 9 foot. I don't care. But when you take a shower, do you face the shower head or do you face away from the shower head? We ain't talking about when you washing your crack. When you initially get in the shower and you just start washing, do you face the shower or face away from it?
I face the shower.
Face the shower.
Yeah.
All right, yeah. I face the shower too, baby. You know I'm tall.
I face the shower.
I'm a big dude. You know I'm all up in there.
Sure.
I'm hitting them old school. Get that.
It's time for percolator.
It's time for percolator.
Oh, Skate Haven. You the trade you know about Skate Haven. Y'all know.
What? You don't know nothing, Nick. All right, Nick, let me ask you another relationship question.
Mm-hmm.
You ever seen a female that you only thought you like the idea of dating? You ever seen a female you only like you know the relationship would never work out.
At all. No
but
way.
But the idea of dating her would be perfect. You just, in your head, you like, man, if I got her, we'd be doing this, and this. And the worst thing you can do is speak to her. You ever spoke to a chick that you like for a long time and she just, ugh.
And-